Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. In this class, we are going to discuss chemical reactions of ethers. In the last class, we discussed about physical properties of ethers, that is boiling points and solubilities or miscibility. Now in today's class, this is the topic, chemical reactions of ethers. The first reaction is cleavage of carbon oxygen bond. Cleavage of carbon oxygen bond in ethers. Cleavage of carbon oxygen bond in ethers. Very, very, very important reaction for the CET, NEET, and JEE. Very, very, very important. Ethers. Suppose I'm going to take the general formula. R single bond, O single bond, R. This is a general representation of ether. When this is going to react with hydrogen halides. Hydrogen halides. Yesterday we studied hydrogen halide is HX. Here we can take HF or HCl or HBr or HI. All of you know, among the hydrogen fluoride, hydrogen chloride, hydrogen bromide, hydrogen iodide, these are the hydrogen halides. Which one is more reactive? Which one is more reactive? Hydrogen iodide is more reactive because hydrogen iodide is having hydrogen single bond iodine. Hydrogen fluoride is having hydrogen single bond fluorine. Between the hydrogen and fluorine, here the bond length is small. Between the hydrogen and iodine, the bond length is large. As the bond length increases, bond enthalpy or bond energy get decreases. So here the bond can be broken easily to give H plus ions and I minus ions. Once again, in the hydrogen halides, hydrogen iodide is more reactive, whereas hydrogen fluoride is less reactive. So once I am going to write the order of reactivity, order of reactivity of hydrogen halides, which one is more reactive? Hydrogen iodide is more reactive than hydrogen bromide, than hydrogen chloride, than hydrogen fluoride. So in the cleavage of carbon oxygen bond in ethers, when I am going to say the hydrogen halide, mostly I am going to take either hydrogen iodide or hydrogen bromide, because these are more reactive than HCl and HF. Right? Yes. H plus ion. Hydrogen contains partial positive charge. Halogen contain partial negative charge. Hydrogen halide. Now, this H plus ion, suppose going to react with alkyl group. Whether it is possible? Because the alkyl group, if it is going to contain partial positive charge, the rest of the group is going to contain, the rest of the group is going to contain partial negative charge. Then, partially positively charged spaces reacts with partially negatively charged spaces to give alkyl halides, Rx compounds. Rx compounds are called as alkyl halides. And RO minus, that is the alkoxide. The alkoxide is going to react with H plus ion to give ROH. ROH compounds are called as alcohols. So simply I am going to write the reaction. What are going to react with each other? Ether is going to react. ROR compound, that is the ether is going to react with hydrogen halide. What are the products? The products are alkyl halides. Sorry. Once again, when ether is going to react with hydrogen halides, alkyl part is going to react with halide ion. The alkyl part is going to react with halide ion to give alkyl halide. RO minus called as alkoxide ion. Alkoxide ion reacts with H plus ion to give the alcohol. So finally, we can say that whenever the ethers are going to react with hydrogen halides, the products are, two are the products. One is the alkyl halide, second one is the alcohol. Now, the question will arise. Suppose if I am going to take the ether, unsymmetrical ether. Here methyl group is taken, here ethyl group is taken. This is the methyl group, this is the ethyl group. So the compound is called as, the compound is called as ethyl C2H5, ethyl CH3, methyl, single bond was single bond, ether. Once again, C2H5, single bond O, single bond CH3, the compound is called as ethyl methyl ether. When this ethyl methyl ether is going to react with hydrogen bromide, hydrogen bromide, what will be the products? What will be the products? Can anybody guess what will be the products? Can anybody guess what will be the products? Here, two possibilities are there. I'm going to write the two possibilities. First possibility and second possibility. The first possibility is, suppose if methoxide group is taken, CH3O-, methoxide group is taken, the methoxide group can react with H+ ion. Methoxide group can react with H+ ion to give methyl alcohol. And this is the ethyl group reacts with bromide ion. Ethyl group reacts with bromide ion to give ethyl bromide. This is the first possibility. By taking the methoxide as the negative part of the ether, instead of taking methoxide, if I am going to take ethoxide as the negative part of the ether, ethoxide, C2H5O-, ethoxide going to react with H+ ion. Ethoxide going to react with H+ ion. That gives ethyl alcohol plus, this is the methyl group, that is the positive part of the ether. The positive part of the ether is going to react with negative part, CH3 plus Br minus, that is CH3Br. Yes, the doubt, question will arise. In this reaction, which type of ether is taken? Which type of ether is taken when a mixed ether is taken? This is the methyl group, this is the ethyl group. Which type of groups are there in the ether? Which type of groups are there in the ether? Different types of alkyl groups are there. In the ether, different types of alkyl groups are there. This type of ethers are called as mixed ethers. So whenever a mixed ether is going to react with hydrogen halide, two types of possibilities are there. Methoxide group reacts with H+ ion, gives methyl alcohol. Ethyl group reacts with bromide ion, gives ethyl bromide. This is the first possibility. And the second possibility is ethoxide. Ethoxide is going to react with H+ ion to give the ethyl alcohol. CH3 plus react with Br- ion to give CH3Br. Can anybody guess among the first reaction and second reaction, or among the first possibility and second possibility, which is going to be the major reaction? Whether the first reaction is the major reaction or the second reaction is the major reaction. Can anybody guess? Can anybody guess whether the first reaction is major reaction or the second reaction is major reaction? Yes, who's that one? Gayatri, Manisha. So first reaction is going to be the major reaction. First reaction is going to be the major reaction. Why the first reaction is going to be the major reaction? So here, what are the major products? In this reaction, the major products are methyl alcohol, CH3OH. CH3OH is called as methyl alcohol, and C2H5Br. C2H5Br is known as ethyl bromide. The C2H5Br, that is known as ethyl bromide. Whereas if the second possibility is there, C2H5OH is formed. C2H5OH is called as ethyl alcohol, and CH3Br is called as methyl bromide. So among these two possibilities, which is not a possible reaction? Second reaction is not a possible reaction. The first reaction is possible. Of course, it is also possible, but less favorable. Why these products are favorable, but not these products? Yes, coming to this ether. Once you see this ether, C2H5, single bond O, single bond CH3. And this is the hydrogen halide, HBr. hydrogen bromide. This is an example of hydrogen halide. That is an acid. Hydrogen bromide, it is an acid. Acid is going to donate H plus ion. Once again, the acid is going to donate H plus ion. So in the HBr, what is going to be donated? H plus ion is going to be donated. From the HBr, H plus ion is going to be donated. And the ether containing oxygen, the oxygen is going to contain two lone pairs of electrons. One of the lone pair of electron of oxygen, donated towards H plus ion of hydrogen halide. Then addition of proton is going to take place. Addition of proton, H plus ion is called as proton. Addition of proton is called as protonation reaction. Once again, Protonation of ether is going to take place to give C2H5 single bond O. Oxygen is bonded with hydrogen. And now oxygen is going to possess positive charge. Due to loss of electrons, oxygen is going to get positive charge and bonded with CH3. So this is the first intermediate. Due to addition of proton to the ether, the obtained intermediate is called as protonated ether. The obtained ether is known as protonated ether. So, of course, in the protonated ether, if you observe the oxygen, oxygen is going to contain positive charge. Actually, oxygen is electronegative atom that should possess negative charge. So, to remove this positive charge, the bond is going to be broken. There are three possibilities. The bond will be broken between carbon and oxygen. But not bond between oxygen and hydrogen. Because we are studying the reactions. Cleavage of carbon-oxygen bond in ethers. So between this carbon and oxygen, the bond may get broken. Or between this carbon and oxygen, the bond may get broken. So cleavage of carbon and oxygen bond in ethers. Two types of possibilities are there when the mixed ether is taken. Whenever the mixed ether is taken, the cleavage of carbon-oxygen bond can take place in two possibilities. Right, what is the first possibility? Yes, see here. C2H5, single bond O, single bond H, oxygen with positive charge, single bond CH3. This is the protonated ether. So the protonated ether is going to undergo cleavage of carbon oxygen bond again in two possibilities. If the bond is going to be broken between this carbon and oxygen, CH3 carbon and oxygen, what you will get? You will get CH3 plus, because carbon is going to lose the electrons. CH3 plus is called as methyl carbocation. So whenever the bond is broken between small alkyl group and oxygen, that is here methyl group to oxygen, if the bond is going to be cleaved, then we are getting methyl carbocation as the intermediate. Suppose if the bond is going to be broken between ethyl group and oxygen, what we will get? We will get C2H5 plus is called as ethyl carbocation. C2H5 plus is known as ethyl carbocation. So whenever a mixed ether is taken that is going to react with hydrogen halides, first addition of proton is going to take place. Addition of H plus ion, that is addition of proton is going to take place to the ether to give the protonated ether. Now the question is going to arise, cleavage of carbon-oxygen bond in ethers is going to take place between small alkyl group to oxygen, otherwise between large alkyl group to oxygen. If the small alkyl group and oxygen, the bond is going to be broken. Here in this reaction, methyl carbocation is obtained. If the bond is going to be broken between large alkyl group to oxygen, In this reaction, we are going to get ethyl carbocation. Yes, all of you know the stability of carbocations. Stability of carbocations. Which carbocation is more stable? Among the methyl carbocation and ethyl carbocation, which carbocation is more stable? Which carbocation is more stable? Methyl and ethyl. Which carbocation is more stable? Yes, very good. Ethyl carbocation is more stable because ethyl carbocation is represented as CH3 single bond CH2 plus. Ethyl carbocation is represented as CH3 single bond CH2 plus. Here, this CH3 group is acting as electron donating group. Whenever a carbocation is there with more number of electron donating groups. Once again, whenever a carbocation is there with more number of electron donating groups, that carbocation is more stable. Once again, my statement, whenever a carbocation is there with more number of electron donating groups, such carbocations are more stable. Whereas if we see the CH3 plus is written as, this is the CH3 plus and this one is the carbocation. So this carbocation, hydrogen atoms are not the electron donating groups. So methyl carbocation is having no electron donating groups. Once again, the methyl carbocation is having no electron donating groups. So methyl carbocation is a less stable carbocation, whereas ethyl carbocation is having one electron donating group. As a result, the carbocation is going to be more stable. Yes, once again, coming to this same reaction once again, in a brief manner. First, we are taking a mixed ether. The mixed ether is reacting with hydrogen halide. The mixed ether taken is C2H5, single bond O, single bond CH3. It is protonated. Addition of proton is called as protonation. Now, the obtained ether is called as protonated ether. Protonated ether. After the formation of protonated ether only, there is a cleavage of carbon oxygen bond is going to take place. Yes, tell me. Finally, what you can say? What will be the reaction intermediates? Here the reaction intermediate is formation of a stable carbocation. Once again, formation of a stable carbocation. Here the stable carbocation formed is going to be C2H5 plus ethyl carbocation. Bond is going to be broken between large alkyl group. Bond is going to be broken between large alkyl group and oxygen to give the more stable carbocation. C2H5 plus, that is the more stable carbocation, and the name of the carbocation is ethyl carbocation. It is a more stable carbocation is going to be formed. Once again, during the cleavage of carbon oxygen bond in the ethers, what is going to be formed? A more stable carbocation is going to be formed. Plus, now CH3OH. This is the small alkyl group. CH3 group is the small alkyl group. The small alkyl group is going to bonded with OH to give the alcohol. What is the alcohol formed here? CH3OH. The CH3OH is called as methyl alcohol. Of course, the reaction is not completed because in this reaction we are having halide. Halide, because the reaction is carried with HX. HX is called as hydrogen halide. So during the reaction of ethers with hydrogen halides, first, it is the addition of H plus ion is going to take place to form a more stable carbocation. Later, the formed more stable carbocation is going to react with halide ion. Here, stable carbocation formed is ethyl carbocation is the more stable carbocation formed reacting with halide. What is the halide taken? Suppose bromide is taken, then we will get another product. What is the another product? C2H5Br. C2H5Br is known as ethyl bromide. ethyl bromide. So here you should not understand which products are going to be formed. You have to understand what type of stable carbocations are going to be formed, where the bond is going to be broken between carbon and oxygen. If you understand this one, you can write any reaction and its products. So once again, I'm saying the reaction, the same reaction once again. Within 1 minute or 2 minutes, I will complete this one. Once again, the same reaction. A mixed ether is taken. What is the mixed ether taken? C2H5, single bond was single bond CH3. This is a mixed ether. C2H5, ethyl, CH3, methyl. Single bond was single bond is called as ether. This is the mixed ether taken. So whenever a mixed ether is taken, and the mixed ether is going to react with hydrogen halides. Here, hydrogen halide taken is. Hydrogen bromide. Text me the answer. What are the products of this reaction? Text me your answer. Yes, correct. Ethyl bromide and methyl alcohol. Yes, two are the products here. Large alkyl group with positive charge is going to react with halide ion. Large alkyl group is ethyl. Ethyl group is going to react with bromide ion. A large alkyl group is going to react with halide. So here the compound is ethyl bromide, C2H5Br. Ethyl bromide plus small alkyl group. Small alkyl group is going to react with hydrogen ion, H plus ion, including with oxide. So CH3O minus and H plus, that is CH3OH. CH3OH is called as methanol. IUPAC name is methanol, or the common name is methyl alcohol. Here I written the common name, ethyl bromide. Here I written the IUPAC name. No need to worry, you can understand easily. Yes, for your better understanding, I'm going to give one more example. Is it understood? Okay, now I'm going to give an example to you. Try to answer this one. CH3, single bond was single bond CH3 is given, and that is going to react with hydrogen iodide. Text me your answer. CH3OCH3 called as dimethyl ether. CH3 group is called as methyl. CH3OCH3 is called as dimethyl ether. Dimethyl ether reacting with hydrogen iodide. What are the products of this reaction? Methanol and iodomethane, correct. Methanol and iodomethane. Because here I am given a simple ether. This is a simple ether, not a mixed ether. It is a simple ether because same type of alkyl groups are there. In this ether, same type of alkyl groups are there. This type of ethers are called as simple ethers. So there is no worry. There is no confusion. We can take CH3 plus reacting with I minus to give CH3I. And CH3O minus reacting with H plus to give CH3OH. In this reaction, there is no confusion because it is a simple ether. So the confusion will get only in the case of mixed ethers. So whenever the mixed ethers are going to react with hydrogen halides, different types of products will be obtained. There are two paths are possible. In the first path, more stable compounds are going to be formed. In the another path, less stable compounds are going to be formed. We are not going to consider the less stable compounds. We are going to consider only more stable compounds. Wait a minute. How much time is there? Okay, fine. And one more example. For your better understanding, I'm going to provide one more example. The example is now CH3 CH3, is it visible? Just a minute. Okay, fine. CH3, single bond. What is the name of the group? Tertiary butyl group. With single bond oxygen, single bond CH3. This is the tertiary butyl group. So the compound is called as tertiary butyl. CH3 is called as methyl. Single bond is known as ether. So the compound named as tertiary butyl methyl ether. This was given in your NCERT textbook. Please once check it. Tertiary butyl methyl ether, when it is going to react with hydrogen iodide. Text me the products. Hydrogen iodide. What are the products going to be formed as major products? Very simple. If you understand the last two examples, you can easily answer. Yes, Karuna, very fast. Methyl alcohol and tertiary butyl iodide. Correct answer. Methyl alcohol and tertiary butyl iodide. Methyl alcohol. First of all, here, a large group. This is a large alkyl group. This is a large alkyl group with a positive charge. Tertiary butyl carbocation. See, single bond CH3. This carbon is going to have positive charge. That is called as tertiary butyl carbocation. Positive ion reacting with negative ion. That is C, single bond CH3. Tertiary butyl group reacting with negative ion. Negative ion is I minus ion. So first we can get the product tertiary butyl iodide. This is one product plus a small alkyl group with oxygen. That is alkoxide. That alkoxide is going to react with H plus ion. This is a H plus ion. CH3O minus H plus. To give the product CH3OH. CH3OH is called as methanol. Yes, take the screenshot. Based on this model, you are having the MCQs in your material. Please try to solve yourself. No need to explain each and every question. You have to solve yourself. And wait a minute, I'm going to take the attendance. After taking the attendance, I will continue the session. Very, very, very important topic. That is the cleavage of carbon oxygen bond in ethers, particularly in mixed ethers. Wait for 1 minute or 2 minutes. I had to take the attendance. So from today onwards, the passcode is 1111. Just wait a minute, mate. And every day I'm recording the attendance of all the classes, not of my class only. I'm observing all the students who are coming to some classes, who are absenting to the other classes, each and everything I'm going to record. The students who joined lately, mention me in the chat box as S present, sir. Okay. Is it understood? Now, one more reaction. The reaction is CH3, single bond C. CH3, single bond O, single bond C6H5. plus HI. This is one reaction. And one more reaction. CH3 single bond O single bond C2H5. If you can answer these two reactions, I think you understood the topic. Yes. First reaction CH3 O C6H5. Simply it is written as C6H5 single bond. C6H5 single bond means this is the one. C6H5 single bond like this one. O, this is the O, single bond CH3. It is named as anisol. Anisol. Anisol is an example of. Anisol is an example of. Alkyl. This is the alkyl group. This is the aryl group. Benzenic with single bond is called as aryl group. Aryl. Single bond was single bond is called as ether. Very, very, very important one. Anisol. What is the formula of anisol? C6H5, single bond O, single bond CH3. Otherwise, it is represented as benzene ring with single bond O, single bond CH3 called as anisol. It is an example of alkyl, aryl, ether. Right. Text me your answers now. For the first reaction. Yes, Mahesh Babu, you. Correct answer. Mahesh Babu, you. Yes, for the first reaction, the product is, first product is C6H5OH. Yes, exactly. Plus, yes, what is the second product? Yes, correct. CH3I. Yes, it is the correct answer for the first reaction. Yes, text me the products of second reaction. Text me the products of second reaction. For your better convenient, I am not coming onto the screen. Because I want to avoid the appearance like this. If I come like this, you are unable to see my back. So I am not coming to the screen today. Yes. For the second reaction, what are the products? Yes, correct. Methyl alcohol and ethyl iodide. Methyl alcohol and ethyl iodide. Correct products. CH3OH plus C2H5I. C2H5I. Here, you have to understand the concept is whenever mixed ethers, these two are the mixed ethers. Different types of groups are there to the ether group. This is a mixed ether. This is also a mixed ether. So whenever mixed ethers are going to react with hydrogen halides. First of all, what is going to happen? Formation of a stable carbocation is going to happen. Or formation of a stable ion is going to happen. Stable ion. I am saying about stable ion. Why I am saying about stable ion? Suppose if you consider the first reaction, in the first reaction, you can write that here. If CH3 plus is removed, what you will get? C6H5, single bond O minus. In the CH3 was C6H5, this is the one, anisol. Both are same. In this compound, if CH3 plus is removed, we are going to get C6H5 O minus ion. All of you know this is known as phenoxide ion. Phenoxide ion is going to have more number of resonance structures. So this is going to be a stable ion. Of course, here what is not formed? Here a carbocation is not formed. But of course, even though it is not a carbocation, it is a stable ion. So during the reaction of mixed ethers with hydrogen halides, first, it is the formation of a stable ion, right? In any reaction, not only in this reaction, first of all, formation of stable ions going to formed, and then more, that is, major products are going to be formed. Okay, this is about the first reaction. Phenoxide ion is going to be the more stable ion formed in this reaction, whereas in the second reaction, I'm going to write like this. Please consider. In the second reaction, what will be the stable ion? In the second reaction, what will be the stable ion? Like this, you will get the CET and NEET level questions. In the second reaction, if the ethyl methyl ether is going to react with hydrogen halide, what will be the stable ion you will get? Yes, C2H5, not the C2H5. You have to say C2H5 plus. C2H5 plus. If you observe this one, first one, you are getting a negative ion. You are getting a negative ion. In the second reaction, you are getting a positive ion. Once again, in the first reaction, you are getting a negative ion as a stable ion. Whereas in the second reaction, you are getting a positive ion as stable ion. Very simple logic. This is the mixed ether. Of course, the first one is also the mixed ether. But this is an example of alkyl ether, alkyl groups containing ether. This is alkyl group, this is alkyl group. Whereas in the second, first one, this is the alkyl group, this is the aryl group, aryl group. So whenever alkyl, aryl ethers are there, once again, anisole is an example of alkyl aryl ether. Whenever the alkyl aryl ethers are going to react, alkyl aryl ethers are going to react with hydrogen halides, a stable ion is going to be formed, that is the negative ion. Particularly, it is the aromatic ion. It is going to be an aromatic negative ion is going to be formed. So this is all about reaction of ethers with hydrogen halides. So during the reaction of ethers with hydrogen halides, carbon oxygen bond is going to be formed. Carbon oxygen bond is going to be cleaved to form stable ions. Yes, text me your answer. Text me your response. Whether the class is understood or not. Please respond in the chat box. Please give your response. Please give your response. After the completion of class, please read the PDF. Within 1 hour, I will send the PDF. Please read the PDF.